a lot of younger Singaporeans like myself, we do feel like a disconnect with our past a bit. I look around me and I see these like new shiny skyscrapers and like these like new condos, and I don't really get a sense of like what Singapore used to be. I really think that if we preserve like these kind of memories, old memories a bit more, educated ourselves on our roots, that will really tie that rift between what we're feeling now and what our past stories are. This artwork, I really wanted to show the ephemeral nature of Dakota Crescent and how it's like very fleeting and how it's a representation of our past. The playground itself is very, very important to me, and I wanted to kind of show how there's like bits of flowers that are growing on the playground to kind of represent the memories that are attached to it, and how it beautifies over time these memories and stories along with the estate. I think we've all grown up to have this idea and this mantra that that's built into us that Singapore has very little resources, and like Singapore is a very small island state and our only resource is our people. I think that mantra has also kind of carried itself into the ideology of the built environment, which is why we kind of have to like keep like rebuilding and rebuilding and rebuilding and rebuilding, because that's the only way to kind of keep the city fresh and anew. That's not a bad thing by any stretch, but I think right now what we have to do is look beyond economic and pragmatic reasons for rebranding. There are also much more socially and environmentally ethical ways to go about things, and I think we really need to prioritize that over economic viability.